Hey everybody, today I'm going to show you how to add various questions from PearDeck add-on into your Google Slides presentation to make it more interactive. So if you haven't already installed the PearDeck add-on, check out my other video on how to do that. But for now, let's open up the PearDeck add-on by either clicking on the PearDeck button right here, or if you don't have that button, if you click on add-ons, you can come down to PearDeck and open PearDeck add-on here. So real quick survey of the PearDeck add-on is you have several different question types that you can ask. So I've got here a presentation about whether or not you force out or tag out a runner in baseball or softball or football or even kickball. So what I want to do is I want to show you how to add the various question types. So for the first slide, what I want to do is I want to ask them just some basic questions. How many players are on a standard baseball team? So I can ask a question by using the number question type. And if I click on number, it'll add it to my question type. And then all I have to do is make sure that I add some sort of prompt to the page so that students know that they can, that they have to add a question. So I'll click on the text box here and I'll just draw a text box. Go ahead and center that. Okay, so now I've got the question. How many baseball defensive players on the baseball field at one time? Over the question mark. So that'll be my first question. So I've got here, I used one of the templates to create this draggable. So where I got this was, I came up here to the template library, and it was, I believe, in here. I took the draggable slide here, but what I did is I replaced it with these two pictures. So I'll just show you what that looks like. I'll click on draggable. And here it is. So all of these templates are completely customizable. If I click on this thumbs up, you can see that it is just a simple image. So I delete it. I'll delete the thumbs down. And then I already had this baseball player here that I just pasted here. I had this baseball player here that I pasted right here. And of course, you can see that I've got the text box that I created. And I'm just recreating it right here so that you can just demonstrating how completely customizable this is. I'm going to go ahead and delete this one. So now what's going to happen is the students are going to drag an icon to the slide on this sort of scale. And the question is, I got to change the question. So this is giving the students an opportunity to kind of evaluate their own understanding of baseball. So they would just drag the dot over to the slide the way they want to. Here is where it indicates what type of draggable object they're going to put in the slide. But let's say I don't want a small blue dot. So if I want to use something different, I come over here to the question section and I just click on the word draggable. And because I am on this slide, it gives me several options. I can use the dot, I can do a thumbs up, I can do whatever I want. I can actually change the color. I'll do, I like red, it's easier to see. This slider here changes the size of the dot. You can kind of see this preview as to where the dot will be. Depending on how many students you are going to be giving this to, you can make the dot larger or smaller. I'm going to just put it right here about like a third of the way up. That looks pretty good. You can also add additional objects that can be dragged. So if you have multiple things you want to do, you have the option to add more. Right now, this is just what I'm going to do. So I'm going to hit update slide. And then you can see down here that they've got a updated version of it. So that is the draggable slide. So I'm going to come down here to the fourth one, force out versus tag out versus force out. When do I do each? So I kind of want to know what the students think before we go into defining each one and when to use it. So I'm going to add a multiple choice question here to make it pretty easy. So let's see, we're going to come down here. So I want to explain to the students. So here's the answer: anytime the bottom can be tagged out when the ball is in play and the runner is not on base. So on this page, I want the students to watch a detailed YouTube video about when a force out is applied. So to insert a YouTube video into PearDeck, there's a little special trick that you need to know. So I'm going to show you that right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up here to my YouTube video about a force out. And if I right click anywhere on the video, there's a pop-up menu that comes up and I want to choose the option to copy the embed code. Because what you're really doing is embedding the video into PearDeck. So I'll show you how you do that. So I copy the embed code and I come back to PearDeck. and I click on website, and that will open up the window where we can paste the code for the website. So I go ahead and click paste. And what I want to do is I want to get rid of everything but the YouTube address. So I want like frame border and everything gone. I want iframe all the way up to and including the quotation marks, so that what I'm left with is simply that. And you'll know you got it right when you see the video preview pop up here. So I hit update slide, and then it will embed it into the PearDeck, and the students will be presented with the video once they are part of viewing the presentation. So next slide, I want to demonstrate a drawing choice. So in this particular slide, what I want the students to do is to draw a red line to show where fielder one should throw the ball to get the first out of a double play. So essentially I want them to draw a line from here to here. So I'll choose the draw option. And then in a second, it'll come up with the, it'll embed the question type down here. So I've got my instructions here, and the students will know what to do after that. So finally, I will have another question here that the batter B hits the ball to fielder one. The fielder one throws to fielder two, who then is standing on second base before runner A gets to second base. I want them to tell me if this is a tag out situation and why or why not. So I want a text base. So all I do is come over here, I click on text. My question is on the screen for the students to read. It's adding the interactive response, and there we go. So there's one of every different type of question that is put on here. So I hope that this was helpful.